All right, so I am here with John, and I'm forgetting your last name.
Sostak.
Sostak. John Sostak from Alpha Vertical, and he is the creator of this Miners Summit. This is just a basic, simple little mini documentary style interview. So just got five questions to ask you and just get a nice little idea of who you are and what this thing was about.
Thank you, Vanessa. I really appreciate it. I appreciate everything you were doing here, all the documentation, participating, helping out with all those video. Yeah. It's really amazing. You guys do great work, and you got the best crypto mining YouTube channel that there is. And I got to thank, every time I see BBT, I got to thank him because he made me a miner.
All right, so to start it off, just real quickly, what made you want to create this event?
It's been in like the back of our head for a few years that every time we see each other, the first thing as miners that we ask each other is, how much are you paying for power? At 100% of the time, if you're mining, big or small, you want to know what somebody's paying for power. You're curious, you're chasing that. That's how we make money. So I thought we need to have an event where we put the power companies on the same floor with the facilities. And at the same time, it's even extra beneficial that we also got like Bitmain over here for hardware suppliers, and we've got software guys. We got ASIC Jungle sales, and then we got guys like education with Mike Carter, mm-hmm. even Tone Vase. That's education. Getting all of this stuff together, unlike a typical trade show where you're trying to sell something, we're actually mm-hmm. collaborating and learning and discovering things. A company like Priority Power is so intimate with Bitcoin mining, it's just natural to want to create Miner Summit where tech and energy meet. It's also selfish. We're miners. Okay. You know, we want to make more money. We want to spend less on energy. That's the whole run through.
Yeah. Yeah. No, that sounds awesome. Okay. So you do have a history in investments from just a little bit of research I've done on you. But what really pushed you out of just doing investments and into actually dealing with cryptocurrency?
Around 2010, 2011, 2012, I was trading WTI. At the same time, I just started, you know, you couldn't look at Zero Hedge. You couldn't look online without, you know, learning about Bitcoin and hearing about it, you know, out there in the background. And your first impression of Bitcoin is like, this is silly. You know, this is something that the kids are using on video games or something. But then as you get further exposure to it, if you're open-minded and you're curious and you're into economics, well, for me, I fell in love with it. You know, you see a documentary, I read a book by Nathaniel Popper, Digital Gold, and then you open up a GDAX account, and that's Coinbase Pro. You open up GDAX, and just a little money, you just put a tiny little bit in there, and I quickly realized that this isn't a very easy asset to trade. The market was very thin. There was a lot of wash trading. It wasn't something where you could day trade it. And then you keep looking, you keep learning, and then you discover BBT Mike Carter. And then you start thinking, I think I could mine this.
Okay.
Then you order a graphics card, and then you spend, you know, sleepless weekends learning to mine Ethereum. And I fell in love with mining through BBT, and from Ethereum, I discovered that I'm not a GPU miner, I'm an ASIC miner. Then you buy your S9 and the rest is history.
What was your biggest goal for this summit in general? Like, what was the biggest thing you wanted to accomplish with this?
It's the first one, just getting people together at any size. You know, big things start little. All we thought is, as long as we could get two of the biggest, most important companies in mining, I believe, are Bitmain and Priority Power. And so our biggest goal was to get them. And having them here, I think we were valuable for the other attendees and sponsors like DMG. That would probably be my biggest goal, is just to get started and just get it to a point where now we could, you know, plug in the same people and expand from it for next year, so that we could just increase our networking opportunities and our collaborative opportunities and our education.
Were there things that you know now that you wish you did back then when you started dealing with cryptocurrency?
It's like the things we know now are, you know, in hindsight, some things are sort of obvious, where, you know, miners are going to go where power is the cheapest. So had I had greater exposure to these operations in Texas, I may have moved there a little earlier for operations. Okay. So discovering things like that we know now, and I don't think I'll ever stop learning. I mean, it's impossible to stop because things are changing so rapidly. But my biggest thing is, if you're going to make a large CapEx investment in the ongoing operations costs, you got to make sure you try to pick the right spot in a place that wants you. And one challenge we're kind of seeing right now is there's legislation that's in and out in New York State that is kind of burdensome to a CapEx investment. And at the exact same time, Texas is encouraging us to come, and they're effectively writing legislation that welcomes blockchain businesses. So my advice to anybody who's interested in growing is look at what local government is like and consider whether or not your operation would benefit from that environment.
Yeah, that's really good advice, honestly.
Thank you.
You really want to make sure that people understand it's not just the rigs or the builds or anything else that you're trying to actually work with. You also need to work with the energy, and for the U.S., you need to make sure the state is actually, honestly, more beneficial to you for energy consumption costs and everything.
That's perfect. That's a perfect synopsis. That's exactly what we've discovered. And knowing that, that's one thing is you can sometimes think being first mover sometimes has a disadvantage because you're learning, so you make mistakes. So being an early miner, we kind of discover a lot of things through mistakes we make. Oh, it's spending a few million dollars on, you know, getting power somewhere, and that's significant. Make sure you do it in a place that welcomes you and can support your growth by not, you know, creating more burdensome legislations.
So, final thoughts. What kind of advice would you give to someone who is looking to actually get into it, just the crypto space or energy tech or investments or just any of this in general?
What did Malcolm Gladwell say? You know, he's got a book where, you know, it's like it takes like 10,000 hours to master something. And I think because it is so challenging to be a master of something, I think that's the most important thing anyone can do. And to do that, I think you don't want to spread yourself all over the place. You want to focus in on something that you're interested in. Mm-hmm. And it could be software, it could be hardware, it could be hardware upgrading, repair, it could be electrical engineering. So Michael Saylor and Amanda Fabiano were very generous to speak with us. Listen to guys like Michael Saylor, because he's self-educated and he continues to promote education. He's got a foundation for this. Learning and continuing to learn, to continue to master your whatever your skill is, become an expert. And that could be in anything, but as long as it's in technology and it's around Bitcoin, I think you're going to be in a good spot as you go forward, whether you're an adult or a child.
No, that's really awesome. Thank you very much for taking the time to actually do this.
Thank you, Vanessa. It's so generous of you guys. Thank you so much.
Yeah, no, it is completely not a problem.
Great. Great. And thank you for
thank
everybody
you
watching.
Thank you, guys. This has been BBT, Bits Be Trippin'. I am Vanessa. We are live with John Dostak. Yeah, that'll take a little to get used to.
Yeah, it's not. It's Polish.
Okay. But thank you again. Stay tuned for the next video, and we'll catch you guys later.